last week I mentioned, I think it was last week, I sort of asked people. I didn't do it formally yet. Maybe I'll do it on the Messenger app. Maybe I'll send a formal request or something for people, because I'm curious, what kind of wins people have noticed over the last, going back almost 2 years now for you and for, Naomi and a couple other people. So, and you sort of casually mentioned, well, I don't know if I've had my if I've achieved my physical wins or not, but I've certainly achieved, some emotional and mental wins. I feel better and I'm happier and that sort of thing. And Jessica was saying the same thing, and I say the same thing, right? But in regard to your comment about, well, I don't know if I've met my physical goals or my financial goals or whatever. There's no guarantee when you set a goal that your strategy is going to work. All you can do is hope that it works, right? And if it doesn't work, then you adjust. It's like that little diagram we have about take a step. Am I closer? Yes or no? If it's yes, okay, keep going. If the answer is no, then change my plan, right? So when you say, or when we say, when I say, gee, I'm not achieving my goal here. I had this goal for the year, and I didn't achieve it. It's possible that that strategy wouldn't have achieved it anyway. It's like Anthony Robbins says, if your goal is to watch the sunset and you're heading east, it's not going to work, right? Because, the sunset's on the other side, right? So, it's that kind of a thing. Like you can set a goal, but there's no guarantee that you're going to achieve it. And also, when you achieve a goal, and this goes, I think, for any goal, when you achieve a goal, whether you achieve it or not is largely a function of how you look at it. Like when I went to Bournemouth, or when I went to England, just about a year ago, I set that goal. It was in December, I think. It might even be exactly 1 year ago. I had that Zoom call with Sue Stone. I think it was like, oh, it might have been December 22nd or something. I'm not sure. But anyway, and then we set up that talk in Bournemouth, right? And until then, my goal was to do some public speaking in England, set up at least one public speaking gig while I was in England. And at the end of that Zoom call, I had one, right? So that was my goal. But so I can say, oh, I achieved that, right? But if I had said, oh, well, my goal is to do a talk in front of at least 1,000 people when I'm there. Well, I wouldn't have achieved that goal because there weren't 1,000 people there, right? Or if I said, oh, my goal is to, make enough money with that talk to pay for my trip. Well, that didn't happen either, right? I didn't define the goal any more than that, is I guess it's what I'm trying to say, right? And I think that's true for, like, I use the example of Phil Mickelson all the time, right? His goal was to win the US Open. Well, he's never done it. He's won everything else. He's won, I don't know, $100 million or something playing golf. So you would have to say, well, he's achieved his goal of being a professional golfer. But that wasn't his goal. His goal was to win the US Open. So he's a failure, I mean, I'm being a little facetious here, but because he didn't achieve his goal. But the point is, who did he become, right? Who did he become on the way to achieving that goal? And that's really the idea, I think. It's and people have said this before. You've probably heard this before too, that the real success is the person that you become. The real purpose of the goal is to become a different person, a person to whom that goal is sort of natural and fits your personality, right? Sorry?
Still with you. Still with you. Letting you know that you got an audience out
Oh,
there
okay,
and
good.
listening.
Yeah, good. I can hear you. You're very small today. Almost invisible.
I'll make myself bigger here. Hold on one second.
Yeah, okay. So this has been a really interesting week for me. Actually, a couple weeks. You know, geez, now he's double. Oh my God, there's two of them. There's two parallel reality Gregs here.
Oh, there's the experience of the multiverse.
There you go.
There you go. Let's see here.
There he is.
Hey, hey, T. All right, let's see if I can get this working.
Yeah, so Jessica and I were just talking about, you know, what have we achieved in the last couple of years? And I think we both agree that, in, you know, she's achieved lots of goals, published 60 books or something, you know. And I've published a few, a couple of books too. But one of the big payoffs, I would call it probably a side effect, but it's a great side effect, is that in the process of doing that, we've changed our personalities. You know, we feel better, feel more successful, feel more proud of ourselves, feel happier, probably have a whole different, you know, set of positive neurochemicals flooding through our body, or at least more of them, you know. So we've grown in a positive way.
Yeah, I agree.
I think you said the same thing.
Yeah, I mean, I think I've got greater resilience, for one. I think I've got the ability to be in a better mood when I'm moving towards things and have better motivation and better attitude. And I think I'm opening, I know my imagination is expanding a lot in terms of things, thoughts that I'll have and creativity that, you know, I feel is solving problems. I mean, it's kind of like the weather's changing. You know, my industry's going through a very tumultuous time, and I've survived it pretty well when others have faltered,
right?
Frankly. I mean, not everybody, but some have done better, but some have also done quite a bit worse. And so I feel like I've been able to navigate that and with a greater sense of maturity.
Yeah.
Really. I look at my behavior and my attitudes and the way people see me, and I think that they see a more mature individual. One of the things that I've had is that I've had a lot of requests to do more because they think they see me as capable. So my set of problems, if you will, has, you know, changed, but I think my circle of influence has increased.
Yeah.
At the same time, I've helped a lot more people in this last year than I did the prior one. I think the prior one, I was looking pretty much only at myself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think now I've started to say, well, what can I do to help other people, or what can I do to be more effective here? And I think that is starting to build some momentum. You know, I know this week a lot of my challenges are I have so many things going on because of having done that. That now I'm, you know, I'm really starting to have to pull in and say no to stuff. I mean, and I think then move more towards the core thing. You know, back to my core goals.
Yeah. And, you know, like you said, the fact that you haven't achieved, you know, some of your goals might be due to the economy or, you know, the changing environment, right?
Yep.
Because, you know, the world's different now. And in some ways, you know, it's there's a lot more stress on people, right? I've been watching a number of Gabor Mate videos this week on YouTube. I think I sent you a link to one of them, at least.
Yeah, I was watching it this morning.
He's an amazing dude. He's been around, he's almost 80. And I heard about him years ago because he worked in Vancouver. He was a family physician in Vancouver for 30 or 40 years, right? And now he's written quite a number of books that have been translated, I think, into 30 languages, some of them, you know, or maybe totally, you know, with all, because he's written a bunch of them. And I was listening to one, and I bought one on Audible, the audio version, and it's great, you know. But these videos, there's a lot of videos of him on YouTube, talking about trauma and addiction, right? Because he worked for, I think, about 20 years. He worked in probably the worst place, one of the worst places in the world, if not, certainly in Canada, and I think maybe in the world, for drug addiction, drug use, overdoses, people dying, from drug use. And that's the downtown east side of Vancouver. And he worked there. He set up, safe injection sites, and he was dealing with these addicts, and then for 10 years he was running a palliative care unit in one of the hospitals in Vancouver, dealing with people who were dying, right? And he says that when you're dealing with people that are dying, at least for him, he says pretty quickly, you realize that people choose to die. People cause their illnesses. Not consciously, it's unconscious, but, they cause their illnesses, right? And he says any chronic, maybe not any, but certainly a number of chronic diseases, various kinds of arthritis and autoimmune diseases, he says they're caused by essentially attitudes, beliefs, unconscious behavior patterns, and that sort of thing. And and a lot of it's due to trauma, childhood trauma, And so he says that, basically we all suffer from trauma. But he said, he talks about trauma not being something that happened. He says trauma is not what happens to you. It's what happens inside you because of what happens to you or the situation that you're in, right? Which is pretty profound. I mean, we've talked about the same thing here, that it's not what happens, it's how you think about what happens. And that's what he says too. For more information about this online community, to get your own copy of the book upon which this entire training series is based, either the ebook, the paperback, or the audiobook, go to mindtimeandpower.com, where you can also get a free copy of this Design Your Life workbook.